know that the attack by Delgado and Rooks towards the top of the Col de Glandon was a serious move. And in these last 15 miles, they must hurt their bodies like never before. This first full day in the heart of the French Alps has enabled Delgado to unleash the frustration of more than 1,000 miles spent pedaling over flatter roads. So often in the past, riders who've attacked before the climb of Alpe de Huez have ended the day lying exhausted amongst the rocks of this ultimate challenge. Andy Hampson and his 7-Eleven team have also done well, but there's more urgency now as the Alpe d'Huez approaches. Team manager Mike Neal keeps both of his men in form. He has two cars in a rapidly dwindling deck. Yellow jersey Steve Bauer is also back. It's true what they say, the jersey makes you ride like two men. But these two, held by a tailwind along the valley road, show no signs of slowing down. On these flat roads, Rooks feels at home, and the Dutchman is always willing to help beat the rest. Pedro Delgado sold newspapers to buy his first bike, and he's talked all year of only one thing, victory in the Tour de France. It's no secret anymore. No Spaniard has won the Tour since 1973, and only two have succeeded since the race began in 1903. After the valley, the climb itself. When we come back, Alpe d'Huez, the most unsociable monster in the Alps, will be with us. We're on the final climb to Alpe d'Huez. The riders of the Tour de France have been on the road for over 6 hours. And these are the two men who have so far destroyed the field. Pedro Delgado in blue and Stephen Rooks. All that remains now is the 9 miles climb to the ski stop of Alpe d'Huez. American Andy Hampson still refuses to concede defeat, and along the valley he makes ready for the final assault. The final climb will decide many things. Fabio Parra, Luis Herrera, two Colombians always refusing to give up. Raul Alcala and the yellow jersey of Canada's Steve Bauer, all in the chase group. The early part of Alpe d'Huez is said to be the hardest. It's unbelievably steep and cruel. Yet, Delgado, winner of the yellow jersey in memory of his mother a year ago, is in the position now to win it again. And this time, he means to keep it. Alongside him, Rooks continues to surprise. He's never shown any signs of cracking all day. Steve Bauer has got this far among the leaders, but at last his legs begin to tire and he starts to fall away. The original 16 have splintered, and Andy Hampson has taken the first chase group with Gert Ternes and climber Luis Herrera on the right. The two leaders ride almost directly above the chasers now, who are beginning at last to close the gap as the finish comes closer. Of them both, Rooks, his face a poker-like expression, looks the best of them. Across the valley, their lead was 3 minutes. On the climb, it's down to just one. Hampson lives in the hope the leaders will slow as he continues to follow the strong men of this tour. He can take confidence in the thought that Herrera, the winner here in 1984, is in trouble. This is perhaps the finest ever battle of Alpe d'Huez. So many believe they could win. Now Hampson just hopes he can survive. How much longer will the pain last? Delgado seems to be tiring, but it looks as though Hampson is in even more difficulty as his arms, back and legs all ache together. Hampson tries to shut the force of pain away as he has shut the gap to just 30 seconds. Here he holds the wheels of Ternes and the pace setter, the Spaniard Pino. Up front for the second year, Delgado is being annoyed by a rider wearing number 11. Last year it was Stephen Roach, now it's Stephen Rooks. Hampson, with still 6 miles to climb, holds on, but cannot contribute to the chase. The American has raced to his limit. Bauer, the determination that has kept him ahead so long, is still there. He's not given up, but instead, climbing at his own speed, he's recovering and may yet return to the leaders. The two ahead are showing at last fatigue. Having broken clear on the Col du Glandon, the slopes of Alpe de Huez could stop them yet. Pino, Ternis and Hampston have never given up hope of catching the leaders. But Hampston, with 5 miles to climb, is forced to his limits and no more is possible. The American has to let the others go. Now it's two against two as the race turns towards the finish. On the mountaintop, the reservation of Alpe d'Huez awaits the winner. A friendly word of encouragement for Hampston to keep up. He'll need more than that. Even on this climb, two men are recovering and Fabio Parra is on his way back to the front. Hampston is his first target as he moves towards the head of the race. For the young man from Boulder, Colorado, this year's quest for the yellow jersey is over. Unaware of the battle behind, Rooks continues to drive the breakaway. On this mountain, by tradition, every year, there are more Dutch and Spanish supporters than there are French. Hampston continues to fall back, and such a climber of his talent would never have expected to see the yellow jersey of Steve Bauer passing him as well. The mountains are great levelers, and Bauer still carries hope of keeping his lead. This day in the Alps has left Andy Hampston without hope of anything. Parra has joined Ternis, and now the next target are the leaders themselves. There's still time to win.
Steve Bauer was being encouraged by the fans and inspired by the yellow jersey, was riding desperately now to hold on. With the summit in sight, the leaders were nearly stopped when the roadway became clogged. They were losing time. It was precious time that Steve Bauer needed to hold on to his yellow jersey. But fatigue overcame inspiration. He blew up and lost almost a minute in the final mile. Entering the ski village of Alpe d'Huez, and just a half mile from the finish, the leaders allowed Stephen Rooks to break away, feeling he was not a serious threat for the yellow jersey. After 141 miles and three major mountain passes, Rooks was about to win the most demanding stage in the Alps. Nobody knew where Andy Hampston would finish. For the man who was slated to merely assist Greg LeMond on the PDM team, Rooks was a surprising winner in Alpe d'Huez. Or was he? Of the 12 times the Tour de France has come to this resort, this marked the sixth victory by a Dutchman. Pedro Delgado finished 17 seconds after Rooks, and for the second year in a row, he took over the yellow jersey in Alpe d'Huez. Delgado had conquered the Alps, while so many other favorites self-destructed. On this day, Delgado devastated the